On your WordPress site, there are different roles and capabilities assigned to users. This is to give the site owner control over who can access what on the site. Accordingly, different aspects of the site are assigned to different users based on the site owner's discretion. This video tutorial will give you a fundamental idea of WooCommerce user roles and their capabilities. The first and most important user role is the administrator user role. Admins have complete access to all administration aspects of the site. Some of the unique capabilities that define admin role include deleting other users' pages and posts, updating the core, creating and deleting users, etc. Moreover, administrators can add, delete, and manage plugins and themes on the site. They also have the freedom to modify the details of other users, including passwords. Basically, you can restrict giving administrator access to only site owners, and only trustworthy people who can have complete control over your site. In multi-sites, there is a user role known as super admin. This role has all capabilities by default. However, in a single site, the administrator role is equivalent to super admin. The next user role is the editor. An editor role allows you to get access and editing rights to other users' posts. Editor role would be best for the person who is managing the blogs and other posts on your site. Basically, the editor role is concerned only with the content aspect of your site. Those with editor role can edit or delete any posts on your site. In addition, they can moderate, edit and delete comments on the site as well. Next user role is the author. Authors can create and publish their own posts. However, this role won't have access to other people's posts. They can also delete their posts if needed. Those with author role won't be able to create new categories. However, they can use the existing categories on your site and create new tags. Those with author role cannot moderate or delete comments on your site, even though they can view them. Similarly, they won't have access to plugins and themes on your site. Next up, is the contributor user role. A contributor is a user who can write and edit posts on your site. But these users won't be able to publish posts. Hence, an editor has to review and publish the posts written by contributors. This is exceptionally useful when you employ freelance writers to generate content for your site. However, one disadvantage is that those with contributor roles cannot upload files to your site. And as explained earlier, contributor role won't have access to plugins, themes, or other users' posts. The next user role is the subscriber. Those in subscriber role has only read access on your site. In addition, they can manage their own profiles on the site, such as user information and password. Other than that, they can only read posts and leave comments on your site. You may find it useful if your site strategy requires users to sign into reading blog posts. These are the default WordPress user roles. Now let's see what are the additional user roles when you install WooCommerce on your site. Once you install WooCommerce, two additional user roles are created. The first WooCommerce user role is the customer. The customer user role is similar to the WordPress subscriber user role, where they have read access to the site. Any user who registers using the checkout or sign up option is defined as a customer on your site. In addition, they can access their order history and can edit their account details. The second WooCommerce user role is the shop manager. If you hire someone to manage your store, you have to give them access to your site's backend. This is where the shop manager role comes into the picture. They have access to WooCommerce settings, products as well as reports. The shop manager role is actually similar to the WordPress editor role. Having said that, you can customize the capabilities of these user roles using plugins. There are a few plugins that are quite functional when it comes to customizing user roles capabilities. One such plugin is the user role editor. This free plugin allows you to personalize user role capabilities by just enabling the required checkboxes. You can also add new user roles and manage them. Another fine plugin is the Capability Manager Enhanced plugin, which allows you to modify the capabilities of specific roles, create new roles, copy the already existing roles to new ones, and add additional capabilities to existing roles. Or, if you want to categorize your users into memberships, you can opt for Groups plugin. This is a group-based user role management plugin that supports unlimited groups. It also supports group hierarchies and users can be assigned to any groups. In addition to this, there are a few premium plugins that improve user role management even better. You can check out our article for the plugins. You can also follow the links in the video description for the plugins and the link for the article. Hence, these are the fundamental aspects of WooCommerce user roles. We hope this video has helped you provide more clarity regarding various WordPress and WooCommerce user roles and their potential applications. Check out learnwoo.com for more articles, videos, and resources related to WordPress and WooCommerce. Go follow us on our social media channels, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel for more informative video tutorials related to WordPress and WooCommerce.